Welcome back, everybody, here to your Join the Rope, and we hit the semi-finals now, where we have ourselves EVO Dota 2 going up against Kapai. Now, I'm pretty sure I know who Kapai is right now. People are wondering who KP is and who EVO is. EVO, these guys, which nobody can work out who they are. And they managed to knock out Fnatic, and they just knocked out as well, I think it was TA, just in the previous game. Let's see how they're going to go on this game. We'll jump ourselves inside the draft. Give me some audio from my wonderful co-commentator. I would say it's the sexiest voice around, but then I've...
Yeah, that'd put you out of a job, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would. And I need a harder British accent to ever keep up with you, man. But welcome, Durka, to the broadcast, man.
Yep, good to be here as well. And nice to see, again, a lot of old Dota players that I'm familiar with in these games. Last game we had a bunch of old Serbian players, and now we've got a lot of old Garena players. Asuna, Babar, old Fail Micro, and... more recently, played in Roots with Smorgulig and Marge in Dota 2. And on the other side, I know Gasha, and Blah Blah Fu is a moderator on the dev forums on Dota 2, as far as I know. Not aware of the other players, though, and...
Prodigy, I actually think, is bucking mad.
Yeah, I just looked at his aliases, and I was wondering the same thing.
Because it flashed up saying, oh, this guy's on your friends list. I'm like, what? And the MTW tag is the one the bucking mad uses.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So, Bucking Man is playing over on KP side. So, is any kind of surprise they pick up the Enigma as the first pickup for him? Just saying, man. Just saying. Yeah, but I wonder who the other guys are. Pilildi and Febby?
Pilildi and Febby are relatively new recruits that Asuna has brought in. Basically, his train of thought is he's, you know, sort of teaching people how to get into the game rather than picking up old players who are more set in their ways. And, for lack of a better word, a little bit arrogant in their game style. So he's trying to sort of meld or sort of merge people into the type of gameplay he wants from his team. Mm-hmm. But yeah, fucking mad there being brought in as a stand-in, and like you said, Enigma. Very nice pickup for him.
Yeah, and I'm really happy to see him so far. I've been hoping for him all day as well as yesterday! The masked lady with a rather large cleavage and big shoulder pads comes up for Evo. They pick up the Templar Assassin. Now, we've been waiting a while to see her. A grand total of 2 matches to see her, and we get her on the second one, Durka. Because she's not available in Star Ladder. So this is like the first time in a proper match that we've broadcast here on Join Dota that we get to see Templar Assassin be played.
Good stuff.
Look at those eyes, man. Like, seriously, she's been crying a lot. Like that, it's just like she put on eyeshadow and then just rant, like, you know what, this is fine. I wanna be moody. If you've seen the size of my ears, I would have got teased back in high school about those. So now I'm gonna kill everybody in Templar Assassin style. 10 seconds remaining. How do we now function with Templar Assassin? Like, what do we look for when we look for pick for laning? How does this really function into their lineup? Like, we're seeing KP ban out, like, split pushes now. Like, Lashrike and SK, already a huge amount of team fight that they can pull out from that with plus one. Broodmother, I'm guessing KP thought that in the end, EVO Dota's going to be looking for a four-man gank squad to combine up with TA.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, with TA, you've got a lot of chasing potential, especially if you go for that dagger very early on, possibly after bottle, treads, or whatever you decide to go for, face boots, possibly. But a lot of chasing potential. And then with Sand King, Lashrak, a couple of nice stuns there. Chaos Knight picked up as well. Now.
This is a huge amount of control whenever it comes to team fights, because we've got to remember psionic traps. And these really screw with you. If you're ever trying to retreat back out again, ever trying to play anywhere, they also get vision out as well, depending on where you plant them down. So CK can plan his attacks a lot better. They do still need one big teamfight controller. Like, you got Beastmaster out there, Venomancer Ultimate, Enigma Ultimate, and then Invoker on top of this from KP. Their lineup is solid as a rock when it comes to anything they need to do right now. EVO Dota, they've got the damage. They've got a decent amount of push. They've got
a lot of disables.
A lot of disables, but they miss any real major form of control. A lot of it is still the single focus target kind of stuff, or slow as people run away. But KP's lineup allows them to fight head-to-head, straight on. Because they've also got a crap ton of disables through them, and reliable disables as well.
Well, the interesting thing is, Disruptor is still out there, and he would add so much to their side with that barrier, ultimate, silencing, damaging, lane control, and up with a Chaos Knight, it wouldn't be terrible. So I wonder if we'll see him picked up as well. But then again, we could see Engine Apparition picked up, possibly a Pugna. Wouldn't be terrible. Dragonite picked up, so that's going to be their tanky, sort of carry kind of hero.
It's the stand deliver, throw up an extra stun, and also can push pretty fast as well.
Yeah, especially with those Venom wards and obviously the Beastmaster's Aura, possibly some Forge Spirits up from that Invoker, depending what build he goes, and Eidolons as well. Definitely a very strong pushing lineup there. If they decide to actually go push towers, because obviously they have got a well-rounded side, like you said, they can go into team fights, they can go and chase, they can gank, they can pretty much do whatever they want. Got a lot of lane control there as well. But so do the Radiant side with the Lashrak SK, the SK Burrow Strike, lead up to that Split Earth. Can be amazing for that Chaos Knight if they throw him on the tri lane with them, and then a solo hero on the hard lane top with the Lanaya or Templar Assassin at mid. But everything seems very, very open.
Seems the chat's also chiming in a little bit, saying the Go Audio is a insane TA player. So we might see if he is going to be playing as that. We're looking forward to it. Evo Dota, one last pickup, man. Then we get ourselves into the main game. Just a reminder too, because I know a lot of people have been watching this live stream over the last 3 days, watching the StarLadder matches. We hope to do Moscow 5 versus Mousesports later on tonight, but we will have to get through
Crystal
the
Maiden.
grand final of the Join Dota Open. We're up to the semifinals right now, and the grand final is a best of three. As far as I'm aware, the match for Moscow 5 versus Mousesports will start directly after the Bloodline Champions matchup, which they're setting up for right now, and will take about, it's a best of five Bloodline Champions matchup, so probably about 90 minutes to get through. So more than likely, we are probably going to miss the first game, but we should hopefully be there for the second game. Venture Talk, come with me into having an extra long smoke break in between games. I didn't do that, Vlad. I didn't do that.
Not forcing any hands there.
But Vlad's still casting as well, by the way, in case you didn't know. Casper's doing the broadcast tonight. Vlad was called away to a different event, so he won't be able to broadcast out tonight.
Oh.
So, no Vlad, no myself.
And I
Maybe.
was reading in chat, and Shiva was saying Purge isn't casting it either.
Oh.
I don't know if that's continued or if it was just currently.
I know they've been trading up on the casters from Gosu Gamers because it's pretty early for the Americans to wake up. Unless you're crazy like Ham, and he's always awake.
Limited sleep.
He's always pushing himself to wake up. There's all the shout-outs to kick off the game. And let's also just run through the lineup very, very quickly. So we're going to have Asuna on the DK. How do you pronounce it?
Asuna?
No, Pylidae?
Pylidae.
Pylidae? Pylidae. Oh, of course, it's Pylidae. Yeah, that's.
That's how I'd pronounce it. I'm not sure if there's some special.
I'm happy with Pylidae.
Pylidae. It works.
We got Prodigy up on the Enigma, which we basically pretty much 100% sure is Bucking Mab. Oh, hello. You might have to wait. It is a five-man smoke gank. CM, Nova, 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 somebody, Venno, Novid, and there's the Bolt. Got to wait for it to come up. Surprised didn't go for the Reality Rift. Five men on the Gale. Lashrak Stun will go. They come in range of the tower. Refraction pops off from the Templar Assassin.
Get the hell out of here.
Yeah. It's like, hang on. This was so going our way. Why did this fail? And you're going to put it down? Blue Core, he needed to level up that Reality Rift. They needed to pull the Venomancer back in range so then they could start right-clicking on him. It didn't happen in the end. And looks like Asuna just saying they're having just a couple of issues right now. We'll run through very, very quickly while we've got this pause, the rest of our lineup. So we did Pylidae, who managed to live just then. Asuna onto the DK as Bucking Mad is baiting them out. Why you mad, bro? He is the Enigma in the jungle. In towards our middle lane, we got Babar. He'll be the Invoker. And down towards our bottom lane, we got Febby KR. He'll be the Beastmaster down there. Over towards the Evo lineup. Actually, Evo, man, you should take Evo. You should take Evo.
Yeah, on that Sankinga Blah Blah Foo on Go Audio, he's playing the Templar Assassin. As you said, someone's pointed out that he's a very strong TA player. Blue Core on the Chaos Knight. I'm going to guess that's a German name and say Werner on the Leshrac and Gasha on that Maiden. And Babar on the Invoker, not something I've seen commonly. I've caught a couple of their more recent games, and he's been playing a lot of Shadow Demon, a lot of support play. But it looks like they're throwing him onto the Invoker.
Did you see what I just saw?
Nope, I did not.
Pylidae dropped down a sentry ward. and then started attacking the Observer War of the Radiant side just to get rid of it. And you kind of knew it was going to go down anyway, but Crystal Maiden says, you know what, I'm even going to deny you this, even though it's not worth money, I'm going to deny you the ward. Yes, he denied his own Observer ward.
Mind games from the very beginning.
It's, man, this kind of stuff will trip with you. But we're going to trip, we're going to try it up on the top lane, and funnily enough, it's Lestrike staying in the lane getting the farm while CK sits out on the side, which is most unusual. While Pylai die, he is de-warding on that top rune. Trying to get rid of that Observer Ward if he can get himself some chance to right-click uphill. He finally finds a couple of them and gets rid of it. How are we looking in mid lane? How are we looking at bottom lane as well? We've got Beastmaster versus Sand King. This is not going to be a fun lane for Beastmaster. That Caustic Finale is just going to wreak havoc with him whenever he comes in close. But then again, Axe is on Sand King. We look down the same line. Call of the Wild, once the ball gets up in levels, then yeah.
Yeah, exactly. That boar's going to cause infinite trouble for that Sand King once it hits level 2 or 3. Get up to that greater boar. But that Sand King, along with Tidehunter, a couple of great solo heroes up against any melee guy. Throw him against Bloodseeker or obviously Broodmother. Great counters against them. Denied. Simply because they can push them away from the creep wave and stop them from farming.
Mm-hmm. Just kind of realized, I wonder if Venomantra is a portal player. The pie is a lie, so die.
the pie is a lie.
So yeah. That's supposed to be cake. But yeah, it's close, man. It's close. It's close. Templar Assassin. Watching him. And this is always fun to watch this. Just this starting build out by TAs. What they really want to go with. Refraction is always the standard. And I might have to wait for this one because it looks like Blue Core is going to make a bit of a walk over towards Enigma. Bucking Mad just moves out a little bit further. Again, great on the Gales here by Pylai Dai. And now he gets a 2-second stun on him. Conversion's doing up some damage. Centaur's helping out. And Emo Core. First blood is spilled on him. First
blood. Emo Core?
Sorry, Blue Core. Blue Core, not Emo Core. Why did I think of Emo Core? Blue Core.
I don't know why you thought of Emo Core.
Is Emo Core even a thing?
I think it's a genre of music.
Oh yeah, that could work.
I believe.
I did kind of work in a music. No, I never called anything Emo Core.
Then I don't know. Well, was there a clan called what was Wagamama's old clan? That wasn't called Emo Core, was it?
There has to be something called Emo Core. I'm now Googling Emo Core, and something has got to come up. And what's the first thing? Emo Core, the label quickly spread around Washington, D.C. It's a punk scene, and it's a band.
Okay.
Emo Core is a band. Urban Dictionary, Emo Core. What was the emo in the middle? What the harder version of emo? The older, harder version of emo is what Emo Core is. But I'm pretty sure Emo Core was something in Dota as well.
Yeah, Emo Core was the old Infused.
There we go! See, that's why I've got it on the mind.
Yeah. Because Wagamama played, obviously, great TA back in the day. So you've obviously been thinking about him in the downtime.
Mmm. That's disturbing.
You've got Wagga on the mind.
It's Friday night, man. You got Wagga on the mind. Oh, wait, it's Saturday night.
It's Saturday night.
I lose track of time, man. I lose track of time.
Yeah.
I'd like to say it's not my fault, but really, it happens, man. It happens. I don't even remember what day it is most weeks. All I remember is tomorrow at a certain time, I have to be there to broadcast. I'm like, hell yeah, I'm gonna be there. We're going to broadcast that.
Cast some games.
Yeah. That's what it's all about, man. That's what it's all about. Just like tomorrow, I don't know the time. for the final of Star Ladder. It's 20 CEST. 8 p.m. tomorrow night is the grand final. Or what Star Ladder is classing as the super final.
Oh.
Is what they put in their little grid description for me. So I'm like, thanks.
Super final.
Super finale.
Oh, I think we're going to find a haste rune down there. Annoy that TA a little bit because she's got her bottle up already.
Well, that's why I'm confused. Because we had an extra game today when we're not supposed to. That'll be the reason why. Because they delayed one of the games from yesterday into today, where there was supposed to be one game today instead of the two games.
All right.
Resume game anyway. We'll just leave that in the back of my mind so I can never access it again. Pause is stopped. And we go back in towards this lane. Yeah, but let's talk about TA, man. I want to talk about TA because people haven't seen TA before. So when you look at it, you go through a first ability, refraction. Now, this is kind of crazy with what you could do with this. Just the ability to avoid or the ability to deal off a lot more damage. So you can work it either way. The only problem is if you get attacked, then you lose a lot of your extra damage. And you got the meld ability, which sometimes can get you into a lot more trouble than it can good. But it is still pretty freaking awesome. When you come out of it, you have that armor reduction and the bonus damage. So normally, you look for the trap set up here by TA, or even using it during engagements. Like, she could just pop it off right now and then instantly hit on Mabar, just setting it up. Then we go for the side blades, which looks like Go Audio wants to level up a lot more. 3 points up in the side blades. It is kind of important, Durka, when you do go for a mid lane and you try and look for these last hits. Because if you don't, like, you can right-click through, obviously you get the little bit of splash damage that travels in the direct line. But it's also the range you get from the side blades, which just work out so much better for you. I'm waiting for this mid lane to initiate. Reality Rift's going to pull him away from the tower, and nope, nicely done. Jumps in, Viz, but there's the dust. CM is prepared for it. Crit will be enough damage, and CK gets the last hit in there. Templar Assassin tanked up a lot of that damage with Refraction.
Yeah, the side blade's obviously very good to get the most out of your meld as well. Because if you're using meld and you haven't leveled up your side blades, you've got to wait for them to get right on top of you before you can get that extra damage and minus armor. But Refraction, you can basically think of that as an overpowered Windrun spell. It's basically Windrun times 1,000.
I love how we get to have the chat now going on to the other names I talk about. It's like, man, it's not Egum. It's EGM. It's Enter God Mode, man. Did he just get 121 crit? Nice.
Oh, no.
Not too shabby, man. Not too shabby at all.
Now, as soon as picked up a bottle here. So he's most likely going to be bottle crowing up on this top lane. More commonly, we see DK go for that Soul Ring to try and spam out your Flame Breath, or Breathe Fire as it's called now. And it also gives mana regen and health regen as a standard on top of that active. But Bottle is going to give him, I guess, a safer...
And top lane.
Venomancer.
Yeah, Venomancer's gone. 3-tick and stun going on the CK, and they use Reality Rift to pull him a little bit further away from the tower so they can keep initiating on him. But the damage is not going to be enough to bring him down. TP support's coming in, and Bucky Matt just sitting there with the largest army of conversions, which Evo Jota does not want to face up against. He picks up the CM. Now the retreat back out. Mal of a sudden in 2 seconds. Gale, not going to fly. And Asuna won't want to keep running after this one. And meanwhile, in the middle lane, we got Go Audio pushing Babar back. I don't know if you've also seen two in the middle lane here where we see Go Audio trying to attack. And with that refraction on him, the second Babar sees it, he starts right-clicking down Go Audio. If Go Audio is anywhere near range, even with refraction on, he starts trying to attack that and pop out that refraction so then he can start damaging him down.
Yep, and I haven't even looked at bottom lane so far. What do we have? Arcanes, 27 for 2 on the Sand King. Beastmaster not as happy.
Someone's trying sidetrapped here. Double damage on the Venomancer. Or he should really try and stand his ground and fight this one off. Refraction's popped off. And the traps keep going. You cannot run easily from a Templar Assassin. It's only 15 mana for each of these traps. And he's got the vision watching for it all.
Yeah, Venomancer luckily picked up his boots already. So he's able to sort of attempt to run away there. TA does have her boots as well, but nothing upgraded. So couldn't really chase without having to worry too much about the other teammates from the dire side coming in to help. Mm-hmm. Is that a smoked up effing mad? Yeah, where's he off to? Where are you going?
He's heading south. He's going for the Sand King. They finally want to use something with this Roar. SK is doing a lot of damage. There goes the Roar. Now Malphite, he could have get himself in range. And Bucking Mad, probably just on the edge of that range. Axis.
Arcanes.
Look at him go. Look at him go. Keep on chasing it. Going around the trees. Epicenter prepping up here! He's gonna kill a fucking man! As well as six guys will go. Axe to fly. They go up in the wrong direction. He's still got Sandstorm. As well as a Burrow Strike. And he's taking damage from the creep wave. Burrow Strike is up there. Right click one. Right click two. He needs a third. Probably should have popped into Sandstorm to do that 9 damage he required to get himself a double kill. Meanwhile, on the top lane, Pylai die as well as Asuna falling back past the tier 1 tower. Man, that was the biggest bait on Bucky Mad ever. And now Asuna. Well, damage from the Frost as well as coming out there from Lashrak's stun. And they can dive this tower. Edict will pop off. They're looking for Pylai die, pushing him into the corner. And that is a lot of damage from Edict. 2 seconds on the stun as well. And then they can finish off the tower on the top lane.
Dire's top tower Yeah, but interesting, as you pointed out very early on in the game, they're giving all this farm to the Leshrac. He's picking up a lot of the last hits, 42 for 3, picked up the tower kill as well. Chaos Knight, 1 for 3 on his last hit and denies.
He's going raw.
Playing him as a support?
It's a support CK. Middle lane, we got a little bit of... Oh man, fucking mad! He pops the black hole, now CK supporting him with a stun. And gonna go on Pampa and Templar Assassin. Throwing out blade after blade, Reality Rip pulling Bucky Mad back in again. And Templar Assassin will get himself a double kill. Refraction, no mana for it, and DK comes in. Nice stun after Flame Breath, both hits on CM as well as on TA. And because there's no mana for Refraction, it does mean TA goes down and DK finds himself with a double kill.
TPs to TPs. I mean, TP there from the support Chaos Knight coming in to help that TA, and then TPs from this Venomancer and Dragon Knight coming in. Picking up kills on both sides, so 6 for 4. Looking pretty even. Invis on that Beastmaster coming into this mid lane. He's got his Roar up, they're going to go for this Leshrac now.
Yeah, if they can get it, man. If they can get it. Invis rune, easy, easy position. TPC is coming in, though. And Babar will want to maybe wait for this, or maybe he won't. He'll keep going. Go audio. Look at the damage he does to the Beastmaster. Going down to the Leshrac of all people. And he just stands his ground against the Invoker. Until Sankin comes through and Burrow Strikes, and Templar Assassin finishes off the job.
200 bonus damage and minus 8 armor from that level 4 meld. That Venomancer didn't stand a chance.
Poor bastard. And now middle lane push. T1's had to be brought down. This PA is really strong.
TA.
Sorry, TA. TA, not PA. PA would be a whole kettle of different fish. Well, that's Tidehunter.
I mean, something I pointed out when casting with Epic a couple, I think last week or so, that Chaos Knight hasn't really been utilized properly. He's been used as, you know, the sort of hard carry, farm him up, get a lot of big items on him,
obviously,
try and deal out lots of damage.
The answer, use him as support.
Use him as support. I mean, that wasn't my point, guys. If you were listening, that's not what I was going for.
Lucky Mad, think you've been having some fun here with TA. Yeah, doesn't have his black hole this time around. Dust will pop off. No way to hide inside the meld. And now CK comes through. Support stun goes. He is, however, locked in place. And then the epicenter makes a fly through as well. Babar flies him up in towards the air. And Templar Assassin really low. EMP burn will actually take him out. Refraction will keep him alive for now. And maybe one last right clicker on the Venomancer. Roar goes out as well, helping to kill off the support CK. And Sanking running away. The poisoned up. Very hard to get away from this one, but hard but not impossible. Blink Dagger. We'll come off cooldown in a moment. Crystal Maiden denies herself to a neutral in the meantime. And these wards just trying to keep this Blink Dagger on cooldown, but no one else can chase it. Leshrac in the meantime, with 4 points on Edict, has done a lot of damage to that tier 2 tower and forces a double TP. First from Venomancer, second from Bucking Mad. And that looks to defend this bottom lane.
Yep, and that's Drums Arcane's up on him. Oh, he just bought... What did he just buy? Ogre Club? Okay, so he's not finishing off his drums. Is he going to go straight into BKB here?
Why not? He is support. That makes no sense. That makes no sense at all. TP towards the front lines. It's SK coming in with the Blink Dagger. So there's the Blink in the Burrow Strike. Babar might think about something. It's going to be a spin EMP Tornado. And because he's going Quas Wex, he's got a decent amount of power from that one. CK, 2 second stun. Combining a little bit, not really the best chain off there on Babar. But damn that damage when he comes out of meld. Just destroys the Invoker's life points. Beastmaster's on the run back out of here. And is there another hit? Yeah, there is. Templar Assassin, double kill now for Go Audio in the middle lane.
Yeah, Babar was so close there to getting his Ghost Orb off. Only about 20 or 30 mana short of that. He got the orbs off, got the Invoke off, but couldn't actually Ghost Walk into Invis. And I don't think any of the Radiant side were carrying Dust. There was a Sentry on Maiden, but she wasn't close enough to cause any troubles there. Very nearly getting out of that situation, though. But effing mad, Sol Ring, Boots, he's not looking too good for himself.
He hasn't had a lot of time to farm up like he normally does. I just want to point out the animation for Meld when you come out of that. It is just so beautiful, man.
The big pink, like, whoosh.
Yeah, yeah. For all those girls out there, I'm pretty sure they've now found their new favorite hero. Oh my god, it's pretty in pink!
Bloody dangerous as well.
It's only going to cost your life. Just like 3 second stun here. Look at that meld hit already on Beastmaster. He's down to 16 life points, 13 life points. Get back in there and finish the damn job. SK Epicenter, a lot of damage towards all of KP. TA, well, he tried to do it. Now he's going to find Venomancer, picking him off in that one. And now Bucking Mad versus TA. What the hell just happened to TA? Did she go down on one knee? Oh, it's meld.
That's meld.
That's meld. I haven't seen... Ooh. Invoker and DK, looks like they managed to pick up the Crystal Maiden. But I haven't seen TA hold meld long enough to see the proper animation for it.
Well, it's instantly trying to do the damage straight out from it.
Mm-hmm.
Where's that TA gone? TP's down. She wasn't about 2,050 gold, almost on the dagger, and I'm assuming that's what she's going to go for.
Yeah.
Phase Boots, Wraith Band, most likely into that dagger, and force the defend down at bottom lane.
Such a great way to initiate too with that dagger. Also a nice way to escape. If you get yourself in trouble, just meld, buy you the time for the Blink dagger to come off cooldown, and then you just TP a Blink yourself away. The only problem they're going to have is the Tornado EMP. Tornado EMP as well as Black Colby. The only thing that will pull her out of it, DK's damage would be there, but that's why before you go into meld, you generally will have a level of refraction on. But notice who TA's build. Up to level 12 already, and is putting points up in stats. Only put 2 points into refraction. And then puts everything else into meld, side blades, the traps, as well as statistics. Stats.
It's not like the mana cost of refraction increases and she's worried about her mana pool. There's a dagger pickup.
No,
she has bottle as well.
Mana doesn't increase though, it's a standard 75.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm wondering why choosing stats over the refraction extra instances.
I don't know, man. I don't know. It doesn't make any sense with 75, 50, and 15 being the cost of most of her abilities. It makes her pretty easy. And hello, Trap, going out on Beastmaster. These traps are so frustrating, especially if you're good at popping them off really fast. TP in towards middle lane, blink up here by TA. Invoker does go Invis, and they still know he's here. But there's no dust, there's no gem.
Sentry on Maiden, but again, too far away to be of any danger to that. Invoker in his Ghost Walk. Who's up on top lane? Asuna continuing to farm, got his Ogre Club up. Most likely looking towards that BKB.
Mm-hmm.
But in this situation, a Heaven's Halberd wouldn't be terrible. Though he will need that. Obviously, magic immunity from the epicenter. Lashrak stun, Maiden stun, or Frostbite. I hear an EMP. Lashrak running away from that, though.
Yeah, but you got one set of arcane boots, and you'll be fine after that point. No CK now going support urn. I'm going to keep using the word support whenever I talk about Blue Core.
Well, it's true. He really has gone for this very, very support role.
Double blink. There goes the trap already. Doesn't go off properly. So they pop it very early on, but look at TA. Nice damage towards the tower. Crystal Maiden caught out a little bit too far again. Epicenter's about to be blinked in. He's got to... Whoa. Blink! Okay. So Epicenter on the back end. Now Bucking Mad looking for a stun on anybody. TA is the last one to TP out. Didn't throw the Malphus. Was she inside meld or invis rune just then? Who knows? But they went top lane to kill off DK. And DK TP's at himself. Radiant's top
tower is under attack. Yeah, I only just clicked on that. Oh, here goes the CK. He's going
to
fall now.
Yeah, Crystal Maiden trying to help out with a Nova. She doesn't have enough life points to stand on this ground. And CK, with those stick charges, almost enough to live. But one last right click out from Invoker will finish the job.
Yeah, I was watching that TA TP out. Obviously, it was a delayed TP because there was already a primary teleport up to that top lane from the Lashrak. And I clicked on the Enigma just after she TP'd out and the Malphus was off cooldown, was it?
Yeah.
Was it off cooldown the whole time?
Yep, off cooldown the entire time. I was watching it as he walked in.
Maybe Epic Man was just expecting it to be a faster TP, and I don't know. If it was me, I'd be spam clicking that all day.
Well, they're both TPing to the same tower. That's the reason for the delay. Because they both TP'd top to try and kill off the DK, and then DK TP'd out, obviously, and didn't die. So I was like, okay. Where do we really go from here? I love this little, the vision of these traps. I don't know if people can now see the vision. Now that we're going to see the rest of Dire walk away. Wow, they got the ward there. The vision from this trap is only going to be the good indication. So, nice little ring. We're even during the afternoon. The afternoon time. So it's nice vision on these traps. And these all come out from PA, and whenever they hit, that slows anybody down. And there's the blink in. Try to go for the trap there on Enigma, try and slow him down. And CK rips him in. Still that Malphus stun holding Templar Assassin out. But he's thinking about Enigma. Also thinking about the Venomancer who comes in and misses the Gale completely. And Edict, as well as Pulse damage, drop Venomancer down to a very, very low amount of life. Roar goes out here on Lashrak, holding him there for the moment. But they're not really willing to get another kill. And there's the blink into a Burrow Strike. Keep picking on Bucky Mad. And they'll go a little bit further as well. Blink Dagger should be off cooldown now for TA.
I've just clicked on TA, and she doesn't have any levels and stats.
What is happening with her abilities then? Is she just not leveling it?
It works. She's got 2, 4, 4, and 2. So that means it's 12, and she's level 12. Your math is a bit off.
Oh, yeah. That is true. Damn, what am I going with?
Maybe you had someone else click? I'm not sure.
No, I definitely had TA click. It was just my brain. Yeah, nice SK, double bar strike off the back of the blink. And TA had a finish of the Venomancer. CK will then take care of the Beastmaster. And the tier 2 tower's gone as well. And in the meantime, Asuna's here in the middle lane, just like, man, guys, give me time to farm, damn it.
...1900 gold. He really wants that BKB, but the pressure here on this top lane is just going to be too great. They're going to look to get into this tier 3. Nope, they're backing off, scared of that ending with Black Hole, which is now off cooldown, and obviously the great, great crowd control from the Invoker with that Fastworks build.
Asuna. I don't know his chances of getting out of here. They need a stun. They need to get there fast. I don't think... No, it's not there in time. Smart TP out by Asuna.
Yeah, knowing the rotation's coming, just getting the hell out of there.
It's kind of when we need AC to come. It's like, oh man, he's gonna get the hell out of Dodge. Oh. that's not how he talks, by the way.
Terrible accent.
I don't know what part of America I just went to then, but alright.
Sneaky little trap there.
Did he just use the trap to kill off the Hawk?
I don't think that was intentional. He was using the trap to see if they'd stacked up, but then the trap forced
the man, bottom lane. Asuna, looking for the Dragon Tail. Gonna get it too. Straight in towards the Invis though, and someone's got a gem or dust or something down here. Is there a sentry ward? Or they just know? Because he popped off the Invis and then the tornado, they're assuming she went to meld. I would laugh if they stick around here and just kept spamming out abilities until she went down, but they don't.
Well, they've got no wards up, so that they didn't see the rune pick up.
Mm-hmm.
There's actually, no vision whatsoever for this dire side. And some very aggressive wards for the Radiant side up in the enemy forest.
And Evo Dota, they've got great vision everywhere on the map. Just because these traps, like there's one watching inside Radiance of Roshan, there's one watching that regen rune on the bottom lane, and if the rune doesn't spawn bot, then you know it's going to be top. And the max amount of traps, and now we see 4 points in refraction. The maximum amount of traps at this point is 8. So if you want to commit 2 to just Roshan as well as that ward spot, you can then throw another 6 out during team fights and pop them off it whenever you want to.
Regeneration. Yeah, and great utilization here of the Ancients. They know they need to sort of pick up the experience and gold, especially on Venomancer, who's sitting... Well, he's not too bad. He's got Arcanes and a Cloak up. That's going to be him set for the next 5-10 minutes or so. Just get as many wards out as he can. Mm-hmm. Drums looking to be achieved by Baba. Already got his full staff. So he's got a nice bit of escapability there on top of the Ghost Walk. And where's that Beastmaster Crow going? Hawk just scouting out, sees a TA. Yep, then it sees the rest of the Radiant side romping down this bottom lane. Top tower
is under attack. Not a place you want to be. CM even going to see the Hawk? Nothing meant Novering it. Yeah, yep. Overpin. There goes the Nova. Doing things the hard way. Longest Nova of CM's life. Now the push on the bottom lane. Yeah, CM, what are you doing? There's this thing called a Lashrak who's trying to push out this bottom lane. Fortifications baited out. Beastmaster really thought about going for the roar then. He's got a gem up too. So keep that in mind. Look at the position of SK. Being hunted by that Hawk again. And he sees it. He definitely sees it. He wants to kill it off so he can find this like little fun position to engage from. Radiant's top tower is under attack. I love the TA is able to get 200 crits coming out, even though it's only, 22 minutes in? And she's got Wraithband and Phase Boots. With a wand. Blink Dagger, of course, but as far as anything which helps to deal off damage, and you're still able to get the crit of that height. Blink up, and Enigma gets out.
3.4k up on that TA as well. I wonder what she's going to go for.
I'd like to see. Deso, Daedalus, something.
Well, Deso, what's that, 4,100? Yeah, 4,100 for that. So 400 away from that, not too far off. A couple of creep waves, pop into the jungle for a couple of seconds. Well, Definitely not unachievable.
Do you remember the old TA builds? Because my brain is not remembering the old TA builds, man. It's been a long time.
Deso, Dagger, obviously the big ones, possibly Manta. But now there's obviously items like Medallion you can go for earlier. But TA was never one of my big heroes, so not my forte remembering her skill builds and item builds.
Yeah, I never played TA because people raged too much that I never used traps, so I'm just like, fine.
I'll just not pick it then.
Yep. It's like, so what are you going to do? Well, I'm going to play TA without traps, so you're going to play TA without one of her strongest abilities. Okay.
I'm going to play Shadow Fiend without razors.
That's a wise maneuver. I've done that. And you shouldn't be surprised.
I'm not.
I was challenged. Oh, in the meantime, though, they're going to try and challenge Evo Dota. BKB popping off from Lashrak, walks up towards the high ground. It's like, oh, hello, KP. Nice done. And they should be able to pick up the Beastmaster before he even gets a roar off. Maybe even Bucky Man if they're lucky. Meanwhile, a little bit further down, SK going into the epicenter. There's no extra stun, but there's also nobody who's not affected by a BKB that can be damaged out by this one. But Crystal Maiden gets a double kill. TA buys back into the game. So one is down for Evo, but they're stunning up DK, holding him in place, and bringing him down. Chaos Knight gets to go on a killing spree in the support role. And then they'll go back in for Roshan now.
So much hesitation there from the KP side. They had Black Hole up, they had obviously Invoker, lots of crowd control. All these choke points, they were sitting on the high ground. They could have Black Holed a couple of heroes there, the Leshrank and TA, in a perfect position for just a two-man Black Hole. Obviously a little bit worried that the Chaos Knight may be Reality Rift, but he was being controlled by that DK. So little bits of hesitation there really cost him that fight, which could have turned easily the other way.
Yeah. Well, what really needed to happen was when Lashrak walked up the hill, Beastmaster, insta-roar. BKB yeah. or not, and then Bucky Mag could follow up, but it never happened.
Well, he started his animation for that roar, decided not to go for it.
Mm-hmm. Maybe someone's like, no!
Oh, stop!
Okay. Yeah, it's okay. You can do it. Oh, wait, too late. Damn it. Like, Neiman didn't even get his mech off during that engagement.
TA on 3,400 again. She didn't die. Did she? Yeah, she died and bought back. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I've got to give apology out to the French. It seems we missed Dash and Max before this game started off. Luckily, there's a second semi-final that's going on right now.
Did they not jump in?
No.
Oh, they were in the last game.
They're in the last game, but we missed them this game. I'm sorry. We're on a deadline, guys. Chop, chop. That's what it's all about.
We're late for a very important date.
No time to say hello, goodbye. We're not rabbits.
Down the rabbit hole.
How far do you fall? Well, it depends how big the black hole is.
It depends how big this DK can get.
Imagine what would happen. Alice in Wonderland falls down the hole. So what do you meet down the very, very bottom? Well, I wrenched this weird kind of hero. He was an enigma of sorts. And he played around with a Beastmaster. And there was a man that juggled magic.
A wizard.
A wizard of some sorts, yes.
Definitely. You're a wizard, Harry!
And he was fighting against a dragon, but he was also a knight.
A man in shining armor.
Ah, yes. I was a little bit worried about the tail poking out through his rear armor.
Does he have a tail in human form? Surely not.
No, he doesn't.
No!
But then again, he is wearing a cape down the end. DK could be hiding a tail, man. DK could be hiding a tail. Meanwhile, you won't be hiding the push on the top lane. Evo Dota. Ready to push in. They're looking at that tower. Beastmaster hills off the axis, trying to kill off his creep wave. Spin up as well as the EMP. It's going to take out a lot of the mana from Lashrak. But 3 seconds later, and they'll have two sets of arcane boots that are going to pop off, as well as the urn charge out by Blue Core.
Yeah, and Lashrak's still sitting on that Aegis, so he wouldn't really be too worried about running in, popping off a load of spells, dying, letting his teammates run in on top, and, you know, obviously respawning, causing havoc all over again.
Just saw the play written down there by Enigma. He wants to go in. Roar's going on the track. It's almost enough to bring him down, and it is. Agency Mortar will pop, but up comes TA, looking to push the Enigma back. Getting another trap pop, catching out two heroes. In comes SK with a big epicenter. Oh man, that hurt like hell. Third Lashrak walking through with the Edict. And there goes KB, buy back into the game by Invoker, buy back into the game by DK. Everybody just buy backs into the game so they can try and stop this tower from going down on the top lane. And SK forced back, mech charge will go. Nice tornado, but no follow-up with an EMP. And the flame breath a little bit too far behind as well. Another trap going out by TA. And still on full mana for Templar Assassin. And another 10 stick charges and give a run. She's expending little to no mana whatsoever.
BKB up on her as well, but that wasn't ideal use of the Aegis there from that last strike. He really did want to run in, spam off a load of spells, hopefully die in the middle of them, and pop back up with full mana so his teammates could jump in with a dagger on both SK. He's got Veil as well and Vanguard, so he's pretty tanky. And obviously the TA as well has picked up a BKB for herself. That's Enigma sitting on. Finally finished his mech. Got a cloak up as well. I don't think he'll be going for a pipe, that's going to be a casual cloak. Try and protect him a little bit more, because he's never going to be able to finish a BKB at the rate this game's
Smoke
going.
Smoke gang middle lane. Blink, Baro. Ooh! He fell short of Babar, but the 2 second stun's still going to be there. Oh, nice push back as well as the mech charge. Saving Bucking Mad's life. The trap keeps going, so PA is some TA. Damn this A's.
SA, TA, PA. Too many assassins in this game.
And then just wait for the SK. Oh, wait, which one do you mean? Skeleton King Sanky.
There's too many SKs.
DK. DK, TA, SA, SK, PA. DP.
Are there any more?
DP. People call Death Prophet DP every now and then. No one really does, though.
Really?
It's just, it'll be like calling Nature's Prophet NP.
No problem.
No problem? Nature's Prophet, no problem.
Venno just keeping this warding situation under control. Trying to keep vision. He doesn't want to be smoke ganked like they were a couple of seconds ago on that Enigma.
Smart move as well. If KP want to try and find some pressure outside of their base, it's what they've got to do, man.
Look at how many dire wards are up as well. All defensive wards there. All covering their own forest. They really want to keep this forest to themselves, farm up, and they're stacking ancients as well. Who was that? Who? Must have been a boar that timed out, because there's nothing there anymore.
Yeah, yeah, a new Greater Hawk and boar was just made up by Beastmaster. It's on cooldown again.
Yeah, I just saw the ancients aggroing to nothing and stacking themselves.
They're scared of the dark, man. They're scared of the dark. It happens to the worst of us. Best of us. And I love watching Goetia. What did he end up going? That BKB is done, and again, now 2,800 gold. He's got so much money. What is even his CS?
169.
Looking good, man. 838 as well. Everyone's been involved. 23 to 13, now gold advantage, being 14, 15k going the way of Evo. And 12k worth of experience too. The only thing they're really lacking right now is a Rax, and I'm pretty sure Venomancer is prepared for this. There is a wall of wards, including dead ones. But TA, look at that ward they've got so far into the base. That one Radiant ward sitting right next to the Venomancer.
That's a really nice ward placement.
Anything they're prepared for. Even if you try and de-ward it, you're going to drop it a little bit further down. Because you expect the ward to be between the tier three tower in the mid, and where the Rax is on the top. But in this scenario, it's not. It's up really nice and high. And let's PA plant these traps and look for the openings. Problem is PA can't blink in properly yet. He needs the creep wave to tank up the damage, so then he can blink in. They're still trying to get rid of these wards, and they just cannot. They don't have the right click damage up the hill.
Asuna has picked up a Gloves of Haste. That leads me to believe he's going to go Maelstrom.
I would agree. I would agree. If you're being pushed hard, you need lightning, man.
Yeah, you need lightning.
They call the Maelstrom. It's called the Mini Hammer of Merlini. Jump in now, PA. Going on Bucking Mad. Then he thinks about DK. Then he thinks about Venomancer. Cannot make up his mind. Roar will pop up, holding Lashrak in place. Epicenter again by an SK. And it happens so many times today, even in the pro matches, that people just keep missing it off. Emo call. Oh man, that's a lot of damage now being done to the Beastmaster. Now the Black Hole pops off from Bucking Mad, but he's going to get stunned up as well, so he doesn't get the full thing off. CM with a stun. Beastmaster goes down. And he does keep right clicking them all to oblivion. And Nima buys back into the game. Bucking Mad wants to keep farming, but he has no team left to keep farming with. And he's got a full team around him to bring him down. 32 minutes and the GG call comes out. Evo Dota. Gotta say, they did take this game pretty convincingly. They won their middle lane. The top lane, while had a couple of hiccups, It was still pretty strong. And the SK versus Beastmaster, SK was always going to win that one.
Well, everything they did was very well controlled. They used smoke, they used dust, they used wards, they had lots of map control, they took towers when they needed to. A lot of their team fights were a little messy, SK ulti missing a couple of times. But all in all, a very convincing win here. And again, you called Blue Core emo core, so I think you'll have to apologize to him again.
Sorry. I know you're a happy man. All right, so we got ourselves a grand final coming up next, guys. It'll be Evo Dota 2 going up against either NLD or 99%. We saw 99% earlier on going up against GC in what could be disguised, classed as a stomp. So we'll see how they're going to go up against NLD and who will be our grand finalists. The results are still going to come in for both these games. Obviously, we now have the result for this game. It's Evo Dota taking it out. So we shall return. Ashley, as always, final stats for those guys who want to take the screenshots to see where they ended up with 20k gold as well as 24k worth of experience. But yeah, we shall return. Your grand final coming up soon. Hopefully, Evo Dota going up against question mark. Who will it be? You'll find out.